Another cultural tradition that I am enormously attracted to is the craft of the Japanese people. This is a cast iron sake ewer. It might initially look like it's for tea or something, but the shape of it tells us that it's for sake. That is a wine, of course, made from rice. Traditionally, it was only for very higher class aristocratic people, but as it moved its way into the general population and people maybe couldn't afford the finest grades, people found that it was better if it was warmed, except if it's the highest quality, it's generally not drunk that way, it's cold or room temperature. But this would have been, was used for warming sake, I can tell because the stains on the inside tell me that there's it's been used with water in it. But the elegance of this piece, this is made out of cast iron, except for the handle, which is just pounded metal. But the body of the piece was cast in a mold. That means that great skill had to be made in the making of that mold, because if you were close enough, you'd see the imprint of the beautiful flowers and vines, which is part of the cast iron. They have a tradition of the most beautiful cast iron pieces that you could imagine. So you have the skill of the pattern maker, the mold maker, then the people actually pour the cast iron. They've made the handle of metal, which is pounded thin so that you don't burn your hands when you pick it up. And the lid is made out of wood, which is lacquered, which is a whole craft in and of itself. It's the Japanese word is urushi, and they paint it on and then sand it down finely, and then do another layer and another layer. And altogether, this is Minge at a level that unsurpassable. And I certainly use it to pour sake into it. I don't heat it, but I pour it in there, and definitely adds to the experience.